they realized that to be a Christian was nothing wrong. So they just began to be open about it.
Christianity was once banned in the region of India where Bishop George now leads the thriving Catholic Diocese of Miao. Today, 90,000 followers of Christ practice their faith openly. 30 years ago, there was no Catholic presence at all.
Hallelujah! Hallelujah! I could never imagine that even 1/100th of this would take place in this span of time. All that I can say is, thank God, He has done it.
He's in the Brooklyn Diocese to visit Aid to the Church in Need, a Catholic organization that supports Christians who are suffering and persecuted around the world because of their faith. Almost single-handedly, the pioneering bishop has transformed life in the northeastern part of India, a tribal area known as the state of Arunachal Pradesh. He's built 32 parishes, including a church that features the tallest statue of Christ in all of Asia. He's opened over 40 Catholic schools in the diocese and constructed the region's only hospital.
Some section of the administration was misinformed about Christianity, and so they thought it was something important. But they realize it is the life of the people.
The heroic cleric also dramatically raised the stature of women and girls.
We also started telling it's not enough that we educate the boys, the girls also must come up. Slowly the society realized girls are equally smart.
Through education, the emancipation of women has transformed tribal society. Women are no longer considered property of their families and are free to choose their own husbands.
Everything that we do must be supported by prayer. Not the time, the length of time that we spend in prayer, but the intensity of it.
When Benedict XVI created the Miao Diocese in 2005, he selected Bishop George to be its first leader. Despite what's been accomplished, the bishop knows there is much more to do, and he needs the help of the villagers who live there.
I always tell them, if these churches and these activities have to go on, we need priests for the future, and they must come from your villages.
In addition to faith-building initiatives that have created a dynamic religious community, Bishop George has brought peace to the region, along with a number of clean water projects, efforts that have helped lift the villagers out of poverty. Tim Harfman, Currents News.